still has a solid hold in University Park. Seems like an awfully good night to come inside the Bryce Jordan Center for some Big Ten basketball. Super Wednesday Hoops, presented by Buffalo Wild Wings here on BTN. And tonight on Super Wednesday, the Penn State Nittany Lions are back home looking for their first conference win against the 12-3 Minnesota Golden Gophers. With Stephen Bardo, I'm Kevin Kugler, and let's take a look at the Buffalo Wild Wings starting lineups for Minnesota, and keep your eyes in the backcourt. Andre and Austin Hollins off to tremendous starts this year, and DeAndre Matthew has provided a real spark for the Gophers in that backcourt offensively and defensively. Starting lineup for Penn State and a change in the lineup. Geno Thorpe, the freshman, gets his first start, joining the explosive Tim Frazier and DJ Newbill in the backcourt. And speaking of DJ Newbill, Stephen, his day on Saturday against Illinois ended earlier than he wanted it to.
It was an unfortunate situation here. You see right there, Kendrick Nunn runs into him, and DJ Newbill, all he saw was a raised elbow and felt a shot to the side. So he reacts, and upon further review, the official said it should have been a double technical, but they didn't have a good the view that we had on television, and so DJ Newbill gets ejected from the game. But luckily, no concern in this one. Let's play.
Yeah, no carryover. They would like to see a little more production. Just 7 points in that game. That broke a string of 29 straight games in double figures. And DJ Newbill looking for a little redemption from last year. He really struggled against Minnesota. Had 15 points, but on 2 of 16 shooting.
Yeah, so he's going to look to be aggressive, as will Tim Frazier, and overcoming that taste in their mouth from that Illinois game where the Illini really stifled them offensively.
Just 29.8% shooting against the Illini in that loss on the road. Now back home and going to work. Donovan Jack trying to feed it inside, and it's taken away, but out of bounds off of Otto Oceanics, and it'll stay with Penn State, 18 to shoot.
You see Minnesota, they like to play zone. You may see 50% of the time tonight, Kevin, where they'll go zone and then change it up and go man-to-man, double team at a moment's notice. They're very difficult to game plan against.
How close are they to what Richard Pitino wants his system to be defensively?
I think with the talent that he inherited, for the most part, they're doing as well as he possibly can under the circumstance, coming with a totally new system.
There's DeAndre Matthew poking that one away, and now Matthew, who's extremely explosive, will start it up the floor.
And Kevin, you asked me a question. It's a great question. I think Minnesota, better than any team in the Big Ten, knows themselves better than any.
Elliot Eliason, who's had a very nice start to his junior season after remaking his body in the offseason. He has the first 2 points of the night.
And he wasn't the only one who remade their body. He's had a couple guys who have benefited from diet and working out, and he's had a very productive season thus far.
DJ Newbill on the drive, dishes to Geno Thorpe, the freshman getting his first start of the season, and Oceanics grabs the rebound off the miss.
See, Eliason won't get credit for that, Kevin, but he altered that shot, and he alters far more shots than he actually blocks, and so a very good defensive presence on the interior.
But he's done a nice job in the shot block category, second in the conference this year, 2.5 per game for Eliason. 14 to shoot for Matthew. Driving all the way to the basket and can't get the roll for the rebound. Penn State offense trying to get jump started after the struggles on Saturday in Champaign. Newbill would be a big spark if he can get it going. Eliason the rebound.
Both teams would prefer to get up and down at a moment's notice.
And a foul's going to be called. Newbill reaching in from behind, picks up his first. There's Richard Pitino in his first season at the helm of Minnesota, just 31 years old. Of course, his dad, Rick, got his first head coaching job at the age of 26.
So, like father, like son, I guess you're saying, huh?
He was just at 30 when he got his first head coaching job at FIU a year ago, and now in his first season at Minnesota. Done a nice job so far with the Gophers as Hollins tries the three and hits.
Well, this Minnesota team, recognizing how tough it is to get a win on the road in the Big Ten, they look very locked in and crisp on the offensive end sharing the basketball.
You see those numbers, the 1-8 record on the road. To underline Stephen's point, it has been a real struggle for the Gophers over the last year plus away from home. But, of course, you could say that almost about every team in this conference. It's hard to win on the road.
That's true. And I think Pitino looks at it like, hey, I wasn't here. So
none of that counts.
That's right. We're 0-0 on the road as far as I'm concerned.
Andre Hollins splitting the defenders, and that goes out of bounds to Penn State.
Coach Chambers, in his third season as the head man at Penn State, he's had seven different players that have either led or tied for the lead in scoring this year. It's a very explosive offensive team, although they didn't show it against Illinois on Saturday.
Yeah, they were hit a roadblock there against Illinois, but you mentioned it. They've got a lot of players that can step up. John Johnson, who is in his fourth game after being reinstated here. And, you know, DJ Newville, Tim Frazier, we know about those guys. But they have a lot of offensive weapons, and right now they just haven't been able to put it together for 40 minutes.
Five players averaging in double figures this year. Two of them, Brandon Taylor and John Johnson, just off the bench for Penn State.
I said Shay with John Johnson, not reinstated, eligible because of the transfer. Transferred in from Pitt.
There's Johnson right there. DJ Newville on the penetration, and he walked with it. Oceanix came over to double, and he picked up the pivot foot. Well, our Motel 6 sixth man is Penn State's John Johnson, and since getting the chance to play after transferring from Pitt, becoming eligible at the start of the second semester, 13.3 points per game off the bench. In fact, he's led the Nittany Lions in scoring in two of those three games.
And he's been a boon in terms of offensive production, and it's going to take time for him to really get 100% on the same page with his teammate.
Nice penetration by Matthew. The finish for Oceanix, and a timeout taken by Penn State. 7-0 Minnesota with the early lead.
Well, you see, Penn State is having a hard time with dribble penetration. Nice ball moving. Now the defense is moving. Nice dump down. Otto Oceanix takes his time and on the finish. So Minnesota finding the creases in the defense early via the bounce or the pass. They look very sharp here to start this game on the road.
Well, for Penn State, to quote Yogi Berra, it's deja vu all over again.
Yes.
Because last year, if you'll recall, in the 73-44 win for Minnesota, Penn State was held scoreless the first 11 minutes of that game. Well, here we are, 3 minutes and change into this first half. Penn State scoreless once again.
And Kevin, it's so surprising because you've got the second highest scoring backcourt duo in the nation, and Tim Frazier and DJ Newville. And although they struggled last game, they're at home now. They understand how important it is to not get off to an 0-3 Big Ten start.
0-3 from the floor. There's a foul, and that's going to give Tim Frazier a chance to get the Nittany Lions on the scoreboard at the line.
You know, Tim Frazier coming off that knee injury last year that ended his season. You know, he looks to us to be almost 100%, but not so much to the coaching staff.
Free throw good for Frazier. Seventh in the nation in assists this year. Averaging nearly 7 assists per game. Just had 1 in the loss to Illinois. And that's a game that Coach Chambers said, we're just going to put that away. We're getting rid of that game. Nothing we can do from that one except move on.
Every season, a team has 3 to 4 games where nothing's going right. You just don't shoot it well. You might have a guy that's sick. You might have another guy that gets injured during the game, and you have to adjust. Penn State didn't adjust that well against Illinois. And, you know, you've got to right the ship tonight.
Collins on the drive, knocked out of his hands by Brandon Taylor. It'll stay with Minnesota.
Nice job on Brandon Taylor recovering defensively because there's another blow by. Collins is at the rim. So Penn State's got to pick up their intensity on this end of the floor.
Matthew with that quick first step, lost the handle on the ball, and it's scooped up by Travis. Frazier trailing his Taylor on the play. Taylor, nice pass inside to Travis. Put it on the ground, though, and that gave Eliason a chance to recover.
Eliason is so long and great timing on his blocks. Rarely fouls when he goes for a block, Kevin. Very sound defensively in that regard.
Andre Hollins gets the screen from Eliason.
Good help by Ross Travis when Eliason was rolling to the bucket.
13 to shoot. Hollins for 3. Oceanix can't grab the rebound. Here comes Johnson. Thorpe, the 3. And it's knocked out of bounds to Minnesota. 15:39 remaining in this first half. Minnesota off to the fast start on the road with a 7-2 lead.
Minnesota with a 7-2 lead, 15:39 remaining in the first half here at University Park. Alongside Stephen Bardo, I'm Kevin Kugler. Great to have you with us tonight as we kick off another great Wednesday here on BTN as conference play is underway, but a slow start for Penn State at home.
Yeah, it seems like they have a hangover from the Illinois game. 0-5 from the field, 0-3 from three-point line. Need to be more aggressive, put more pressure on the Gopher defense.
Good look there at Tim Frazier. 0-for-5 are the Nittany Lions from the floor. The only points coming from Frazier at the free throw line. Matthew.
Right now, Penn State trying to give Minnesota a little bit of their own medicine. Minnesota likes to press, change up defenses, put pressure on the defense three-quarter court.
Foul on Donovan Jack, trying to stay with Matthew in the corner. That's a tough matchup for Donovan Jack because Matthew is awfully quick.
Yeah, and the thing is, you know, these Gophers, they take 23 threes a game. So that is a big part of their weaponry. And you have to be cognizant of that, whether you're Donovan Jack or even Jordan Dickerson, the seven-footer that will come off the bench for Penn State.
25 to shoot, Minnesota with the five-point lead. Hollins, the three. Rolls off, and the rebound pulled down for Minnesota by Joey King.
Kevin, one of the hardest things to do when you're in the 2-3 zone like Penn State is right now is to rebound the basketball on the defensive glass. You're guarding the space. You have to go and find a body to box out when the shot goes up.
Eliason down the baseline with the reverse and the foul.
Well, this Gophers team is sharp here. Joey King giving them an extra opportunity on the offensive rebound. This is a man-sized board right here by Joey King. Goes through traffic and gets it. Looked like Donovan Jack had it. And then the pass down Eliason. Nice job on the reverse. Keeping his concentration. Penn State didn't think that was much of a foul there along the baseline.
Eliason with 4 points. Cannot get his fifth, and the rebound by Ross Travis.
So here's the unusual thing. Minnesota will pressure on a made or missed free throw. Highly unusual.
Johnson driving right at Eliason, cannot finish. Offensive rebound taken away from Jordan Dickerson, but a foul. That'll go on Austin Hollins. His first, the third team foul on the Gophers as DJ Newbill returns, replacing Geno Thorpe.
Kevin, you see Coach Chambers running guys in and out. He's trying to find a combination that is good defensively, has some energy, and looking to score the basketball. Just struggle getting good looks.
Frazier trying to find some offense for this Penn State squad. Looking for their first made bucket. 0-for-6 from the floor, making 0-for-7 on the miss from Dickerson. Andre Hollins. He's got Malik Smith to his left, a sharpshooter from three.
Joey King looks like he took a nice shot to the nose.
And a foul as King gets called underneath, getting tangled up with Frazier.
Yeah, he's not happy. He's trying to get the attention of the referee right there. Frazier trying to keep King out of the paint. King gets called for the foul, but he took a shot to the nose previous to that.
Johnson on the attack. The floater, a little bit strong, and Hollins the rebound.
Penn State practices those shots, those floaters right there that you saw from Johnson. That's a regular routine in practice, so they won't go away from that, even though Johnson didn't get that one to go.
And a whistle inside away from the ball. This going on, John Johnson. Fourth team foul on Penn State, first on Johnson, as Allen Roberts, the senior guard, enters the lineup for Johnson. Roberts averaging 6 points, 3 rebounds a game, but he's struggled over the last 4 games, just 0-for-9 from three.
One of the reasons Coach Chambers said that Roberts is going to be in the game is because he understands what's expected. He's a tough guy, so he'll bring some toughness off the bench. And he'll look to score when the opportunity presents itself. But Coach knows what he's going to get from him coming off the bench.
43% of the points off the bench this year have been scored by Roberts. Hollins wants to go inside to Maurice Walker. Instead, on the drive, the dish by Smith to Walker. The bucket is good, and the foul.
Maurice Walker just lobbing that one up, and he's able to get it to roll home and a chance at a three-point play.
Kind of funny when you watch this play. Pretty good help right there by Jordan Dickerson, and he just out of position, bumps into Mo Walker, and Mo Walker gets the shot to go down. You don't know if Mo Walker woke up or he just hit a bucket. His facial expression doesn't change at all. There's no excitement there. Big fella's struggling with his confidence on the offensive end. Show some life, big fella.
It's the guy you want to entrust with your secret surprise party news, because he's never going to let anybody know that there's a party plan.
That's true, Kevin, but we're not at a party right now. They're in a dogfight, and they have the best of it right now with a 10-point lead.
Tim Frazier trying to provide a little bit of bite for the Nittany Lions here. Little floater for Frazier rolls home, and there's the first made field goal after starting 0-for-8 from the floor. Penn State's got their first bucket at the 13-minute mark.
And if you're Penn State, Kevin, here's the beauty of that. You're only down 8 points at home. So as bad as that start has been for them, they could pick it up and get a couple breaks like they looks like they're getting right now.
The foul on Walker away from the ball. Maurice Walker's first and the fifth team foul on Minnesota. Each team's been whistled for five.
So we've seen Penn State with a high pick and roll to get Frazier going. Now they need to find something to get DJ Newbill going as well. Such a talented scorer and can do it from the perimeter, but also loves to get around the paint with that good body of his.
Frazier trying to hit Dickerson, and a whistle and a foul is going to be called as Dickerson able to regather himself down in the block, and the foul going against King, and that'll be his second.
Joey King throws his body around when he comes in the game, and it was frustrating for those big guys when they come in and they want to be aggressive, but if you pick up a quick foul like he did on the offensive end, they tend to multiply.
Sixth team foul against Minnesota. In for Minnesota, Daquan McNeil replacing Austin Hollins, getting a chance to get a breather before the under 12 media timeout. Travis catching that lob and starting the offense to Frazier, who scored all four Penn State points.
So Penn State, Kevin, has been reduced in the second here in the half court set to just dribble drive high screen and roll. Minnesota's taking them out of anything they're trying to do offensively.
Credit to what Richard Pitino wants to do defensively, and that they're able to do that this early in the conference season, really this early in his tenure at Minnesota.
On the road. I mean, this is a, you know, any road game in the Big Ten is tough to manage, and they have come out with a near-perfect start.
A nice hook shot from Maurice Walker, who caught in great position on that right side.
And you know what? Bigs like that, Maurice Walker, Elliot Lyson, they'd love to see opposing seven-footers like Dickerson.
Good shot for Ross Travis, who was held scoreless Saturday at Illinois. They need to see him put some points on the board.
They need to see everybody put some points on the board at this point. But no, Ross really struggled against Illinois. I think John Ickey did a really good job on him defensively.
They double Smith out there on the perimeter. Malik Smith is a three-point specialist, and a good one at that. McNeil bouncing to Hollins. And Hollins took an extra step when he ran into traffic. He had Smith open in the corner.
Well, Minnesota starting out well. Penn State trying to close the gap, but the big fella gets great position. I'm in the middle. I'm on the baseline. Jordan Dickerson, take that one with you.
Minnesota 14, Penn State 6, 11-16 remaining in the first half. Alongside Stephen Bardo, I'm Kevin Kugler. Welcome back to Bryce Jordan Center, where Penn State and Minnesota are locked up in this third conference clash of the year. Austin Hollins and the Gophers with the early lead.
Well, they've come out with a really good start when you talk about the amazing performance.
Our Quicken Loans amazing performance at the backcourt duo of Hollins and Hollins. Could be a law firm, but it's a backcourt duo at Minnesota that scores almost 29 points per game.
Yeah, very talented. Hollins, brothers from another mother, since they're no relation, but have done an excellent job leading this Gophers team early in the season.
Going to work, DJ Newbill. Travis on the drive. Can't get the roll. Offensive rebound, though, for Taylor. And it's taken away by Walker. Malik Smith driving to the basket. And the rebound ripped down by Taylor. Lob ahead to Allen Roberts, leading the field. And a foul is called on Andre Hollins.
Great hustle by Andre Hollins. But better defense by Tim Frazier not to foul when Malik Smith was going to the hole. Watch Andre Hollins did not give up on the play. Got called for the foul, but makes him earn it.
First foul on Hollins. Team foul number 7, so free throws the rest of the way for Penn State. That's good news for the Nittany Lions.
Yes, it is.
Very good free throw shooting team. And, of course, as I say that, Allen Roberts misses the free throw. Well, that defense for Richard Pitino's squad has started to show up. Steals, fourth in the conference, and blocks, first in the league.
And they keep that charted each time out. Deflections, paint touches, steals, rebounds. They keep a chart constantly so the players get constant feedback on if they're doing what they're supposed to be doing on the defense and hustle in.
Does it surprise you that Minnesota leads or is strong in categories similar to that of, say, Louisville?
Not at all. Very similar approaches in terms of using mixing defenses and quickness on the perimeter to get the ball away from their opponents.
Nice job by Walker to get a hold of that ball and do something with it after he got a hold of it. The foul on DJ Newbill for Penn State. That's his second personal foul.
And so DJ is just can't get on track. And no rhythm offensively. They're not even looking for him on the offensive end. And now in foul trouble.
Free throw no good for Walker. Maurice Walker. Well, look at last year to this year. Talk about remaking your body. And Richard Pitino gives a lot of credit to strength coach Sean Brown, who was his dad's strength coach when he was the head coach of Kentucky, who came in and remade kind of the off-season workout regimen for these guys.
Off-season workout plus diet, because that's so big in terms of if you're going to change your physique. And Mo Walker dedicated himself to getting in shape so he could play this kind of style, and he's running the floor right now.
Oceanix hits the three. The transition offense, and Oceanix raining it down from outside. BTN goes where you want, when you want it with BTN To Go, presented by Auto Owners Insurance. Watch live hoops on your computer, tablet, or smartphone. To learn more, visit BTNToGo.com. Also available in the App Store and on Google Play. Download it today.
A little pseudo pressure by the Gophers here. Inbound. This has been Penn State's offense right here. High spin and roll for Tim Frazier.
Tim Frazier now with 6 points for Penn State. And there's a travel by Daquan McNeil.
Take a look at the high screen and roll. They're trying to force him into the help. Eliason doesn't close quick enough. There's that floater again, that runner, Kevin, that we've seen 3 or 4 times here in the first half.
Well, Penn State, Stephen, is 3 of 15 from the floor to start this game. And they look up halfway through the first half, and they're down just 8 points. They have to feel like, you know what, if they can weather the storm, get Tim Frazier doing things like that, they've got a shot.
Well, they've got to get some stops on this end of the floor. Their offense, even though they haven't shot the ball very well, a lot of teams in the college level will play defense according to how they're playing offense.
Johnson on the attack all the way in, and another shot changed by Eliason, and here comes Minnesota.
That's just not a very good shot by Johnson. You're starting to get a little bit of momentum. Give the ball back to Tim Frazier. He's got the hot hand.
Frazier with 8 of the Nittany Lions' 11 points. Matthew with 14 to shoot.
Penn State's done a good job on Matthew thus far, not allowing him any dribble penetration to the rim.
They'll take dribble penetration from Malik Smith as they block that away. Frazier on the other end, on the attack. He is fouled by Austin Hollins, and that'll send Frazier to the line as Austin Hollins picks up his second personal foul.
So Penn State struggling from the field, can't get anybody going offensively. Give the ball to Tim Frazier, let him create.
8th team foul on Minnesota. So Frazier, an 81% free throw shooter, will go to the line. two for two tonight.
Over the last couple of years, there's not been a more productive player in college basketball, not just in the Big Ten, but in the country, in terms of points, assists, rebounds. He means so much to this program. And now, you know, there's a lot of optimism with DJ Newbill, John Johnson, Jordan Dickerson becoming eligible. They have the makings of some depth and some scoring ability now, but they've gotten out of the block so slowly here in the Big Ten Conference.
Well, tonight's a big night for Penn State. At home, trying to avoid an 0-3 start in the league for the second straight year. The three from Malik Smith, a little bit strong. Oceanix taps the rebound to Taylor. And now Penn State down by four with the ball.
Great box out that time by Penn State. Whenever the ball can drop from a shot, that's great box out.
6-0 run for the Nittany Lions, and then a whistle, and that's over and back. So it goes right back on the turnover to Penn State.
Good outlet by Elliott Eliason, but Malik Smith is a designated shooter. He doesn't like handling basketball too much, so a fortunate break for the Gophers. We've got to keep an eye on Otto Oceanix and Brandon Taylor. They've been elbowing and talking to each other a little bit, so we got to keep an eye on that duo as long as they're on the floor together.
Seventh turnover in this first half for Minnesota. Only three so far for Penn State. That's one thing Minnesota does is they turn teams over, but they've not been able to do it so far.
Penn State hasn't been bad, but the thing that's really saved them are those seven turnovers by the Gophers, because if they don't have that many, Penn State might be in trouble right now.
Taylor can't connect. Oceanix the rebound away from Eliason.
Not a bad look for Penn State getting the ball inside. Getting into that paint via the bounce, the pass, or big man scoring.
Allen Roberts commits the foul inside. 7:34 to play, first half. Minnesota's lead is four. Minnesota 17, Penn State 13, 7:34 remaining first half. That man is the man in charge right now of the Penn State football program. Larry Johnson, the interim football head coach, because, of course, Bill O'Brien leaves to take over the Houston Texans. Of course, the Patriots assistant coach for several years, hired as Penn State head coach January 8 of 2012. The national coach, the Big Ten coach of the year in 2012, but continued his very good run, albeit shorter than most Penn State fans would have liked, with a 7-5 record this year for Penn State. Really doing a nice job of weathering the storm at Penn State, keeping that football program relevant, and now a man who has been a part of Penn State football for a very long time, Larry Johnson, is right now the interim head coach, keeping everybody on the same page, awaiting the announcement of a new head coach.
I guess there's an announcement imminent within a day or two about what the future of the program, but I guess he's over there tweeting that he's over here checking out the Penn State basketball game.
That is a man who's been a big part of Penn State football over the years, and we wish him and the Penn State football program very well. 19-13, Minnesota with the 6-point lead. Those seven turnovers, a big part of the story, though, keeping Penn State in this game, despite the fact that Nittany Lions are 4 of 19 from the floor in the first half.
Well, if you've had Pat Chambers, you're thinking everything that could go wrong has gone wrong. DJ Newbill, two fouls, not in the game. Struggling from the field, just no offensive rhythm.
But there's Brandon Taylor, who hits the jumper in the corner, and the three falls for Taylor to bring him within three.
And that's why it's so difficult as college coaches to get 18 and 22-year-olds to understand, stick with the system. Even if you're not shooting well, even things aren't going well, if you keep with the system, you keep playing hard, you keep defending, eventually it will come back. That's what we're seeing with the Nittany Lions right now.
First made three of the night for Penn State coming from Brandon Taylor, and the Nittany Lions within three. Eliason looking for Hollins. There's a foul going to be called on Geno Thorpe. And for Thorpe, that's his first personal foul. Penn State's 8. And speaking of Twitter, you can get involved in the Twitter conversation around tonight's game. Go to btn.com/connect. BTN Connect is presented by Buick. You'll see Larry Johnson's tweet. Many others on BTN Connect. Andre Hollins cannot hit the free throw and the rebound to Frazier. And now with a three, Penn State can tie it up. Johnson will attack, and he banks it off the glass over Eliasson, and Penn State's within one.
Wow, John Johnson, he is slight of build but strong. Going to the hole with a weight room shot. That's what we call weight room, and you take the contact and still finish.
Matthew on the drive trying to break that Penn State run. It's 11-2 on the run after the Johnson fouls some free throws, but look at this drive once more.
Tim Frazier doing a great job of collapsing the defense, and Frazier right there taking it to the chest of the shot blocking Eliasson. That's what you do as a guard. You got to go through what my old coach called the snot box. Go right up through the face and through the nose and go to the rim. John Johnson showing you some old school game.
That must be why I was never successful. Anytime the snot box would get mentioned, I'd just go, ew, and back away. Lose the ball.
Yeah, that's old terminology. Go through the chest and through the nose. I should have probably said that. That would have been a little bit easier.
It's much more colorful, though. 20-18, Minnesota by two. See what you learn when you watch hoops games on BTN?
That's right. Now it looks like they're trying to go to a set play where before they were going all high pick and roll.
Foul inside against Malik Smith of Minnesota. And for Smith, his first. Free throws have been a story tonight as well. Penn State is 5 of 6 at the line, but add those 7 turnovers for Minnesota with a 4-for-9 performance in the first half of the line. They're leaving points and possessions out there on the floor.
They are, and that's a mental area where Richard Pitino, I'm sure, is going to address at halftime, recognizing how difficult it is to win on the road.
Eliasson off that miss. Matthew, quick attack. Smith on the drive. Malik Smith can't get it. Elliott Eliasson, tough rebound, and he'll go to the line. Was that about a man's rebound earlier? That was certainly a good example from Elliott Eliasson.
Well, blood and elbows flying here. And good job of Eliasson taking the hit the first time. When he got the rebound, looked like he got hit in the head, but had a presence of mind to keep it high and try to finish.
First foul on Tim Frazier. And Minnesota's woes at the line continue. Now 4-for-10 at the free throw line.
It's unbelievable how contagious that can be among teams that are normally pretty good from the line.
Well, remember, this is the best free throw shooting team in the conference coming into play this week. 76%, 12th in the nation, but they're 4-for-11 at the charity stripe.
So you see that, again, when you see your teammates struggle from line, especially Andre Hollins, as good as he is from the line, when you see your teammates struggle like that, it becomes contagious, and this is unbelievable. If Tim Frazier can hit these two free throws, we have a tie ball game.
Tim Frazier, pretty good guy to have at the line when you're looking for a tie at the line, as Roberts checks back in for Brandon Taylor. That foul a moment ago on DeAndre Matthew, his first. Each team well over the limit now, 10 fouls apiece, and the free throws made per game and the percentage of the offensive output that comes from free throws. Almost a quarter of each of these teams' points come at the free throw line.
Highest in the Big Ten for both of these teams. And so the dribble penetration, putting pressure on the defense, is really key to both offenses.
And Jordan Dickerson waking up the crowd a little bit here at the Bryce Jordan Center with the block. Seven-footer with the swat. And Minnesota with 25 to shoot as it went out of bounds.
Sound like a little beach volleyball there, but it's far too cold for that here in University Park.
Matthew with 15 to shoot. And Malik Smith with 10 on the shot clock. Here's Matthew. Oceanic's going to try to go. 4 to shoot. Oceanic throws it away. The takeaway by Geno Thorpe. And now Penn State can grab the lead. On the drive, Thorpe pulls it home, and for the first time tonight, the Nittany Lions have the lead and a timeout taken by Minnesota.
Take a look here at this nice steal, and Penn State understanding Minnesota scrambling to get back defensively. right there going straight again to the big man's chest, Kevin. They're not allowing his length to block the shot. They're jumping into him to nullify his length and going up strong at the bucket. Nice job by the freshman, Thorpe.
21-20, Penn State with the lead. Geno Thorpe averaging 3 points per game, but shooting almost 57% from the floor. Hockey returns with the debut of Frozen Fridays. First, Ohio State takes on Michigan State. Then it's Michigan and Wisconsin. BTN Frozen Fridays presented by Buffalo Wild Wings. Friday night on BTN and BTN to go. 14-3 run for Penn State. Minnesota with the three from Smith. A little bit strong. And the rebound for the Nittany Lions. On the drive and a foul, and more free throws coming. As Penn State has just continued now to attack, 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 and get themselves to the foul line.
Yeah, and that's a way of getting through periods of offensive struggle that we've seen around the country now, especially with the way that things are being called with this freedom of movement. To put your head down to get to the rim and either force contact or get all the way to the rim and challenge a shot blocker.
It's so good for Frazier. He's got 12.
So, again, when you look at this, it's poorly. Minnesota shot the, or excuse me, Penn State shot the basketball here in the first half. DJ Newbill, your leading scorer on the bench with two fouls. Getting their first bucket at the 12-minute mark in the first half. And they're up 3 points here with 4.5 minutes left. What a turnaround in this ballgame.
Andre Holland to Maverick Ahanmisi. Matthew on the drive. Off the window, can't get the roll. The rebound to Frazier. Inside, great work and a strong finish from Ross Travis. And Penn State leads by 5, 25-20.
Penn State has abandoned their half-court offense. They are pushing the basketball every single time and letting Tim Frazier break down the defense.
Ahanmisi inside Eliason, and that's their first field goal since the 10:04 mark in the first half. What a drought from the floor. The points had come at the line for Minnesota.
That's the situation of good offense, but also those turnovers that you mentioned, Kevin, shooting themselves in the foot when they had that lead to not being able to extend it here in the first half.
Penn State by 3, 3.5 to go until halftime. The turnaround for Travis just a little strong, and Elias in the rebound. And now Matthew will push to Hollins. And a foul is going to be called on Graham Woodward. 25-22. Penn State by 3 with 3:22 to play in the first half.
Well, Penn State having to get everybody back from that slumber at Illinois. Ross Travis, the Shaska, Minnesota native, giving it some to Minnesota. Have some, fellas. Welcome back to University Park, where Penn State has clawed their way into a lead on the back of Tim Frazier, getting it done in the paint area. You don't see any settled jumpers. And then one of the things he does extremely well, great pass to Ross Travis along the baseline. He is single-handedly, Kevin, got Penn State back in this game.
An 18-5 run. Frazier with 13 points. The rest of the team is 5-for-21 from the floor. So if you're not hitting shots, give it to your best player, arguably, and let him drive to the bucket and get to the foul line. That's exactly what Penn State's done to get this lead.
And remember now, their leading scorer, DJ Newbill, has been on the bench for a good part of this first half with two fouls. So Tim Frazier really doing this without his backcourt partner in crime.
Yeah, the foul trouble started to mount for each team. Austin Hollins, Joey King, Malik Smith, two fouls apiece for Minnesota. Meanwhile, for Penn State, two for Donovan Jack, two for Newbill, and two for John Johnson.
So a lot of foul trouble for Penn State, but able to overcome it here.
Geno Thorpe on the drive. Oceanics with a block, but right there to put it back in is Ross Travis.
And see, that's the type of player Ross Travis is in terms of getting to the offensive glass, being strong in traffic. He got that layup to go. Now his offense and confidence has elevated.
Hollins the three. Halfway down, and it popped back up. Frazier again on the push. Nice pass to Thorpe, who runs it in. That's a speedy combo, Frazier to Thorpe.
Wasn't it not too long ago Penn State had 2 points?
For a good portion of the first half, yes.
And now there are five. It's as though Minnesota's forgotten how to score on this end of the floor.
It'll belong to Penn State off the Matthew miss. Now Ross Travis getting inside with some putback.
Well, there's so much pressure on the front line right now of the Gophers with Penn State really driving hard to the rim. And Travis able to clean up, and then that's just hustle right there. They're beating the Gophers down the floor.
And that's going to be something that really frustrates Minnesota head coach Richard Pitino. It's one thing to lose a game. It's another thing to get beaten down the floor when you're a team that really prides itself on defense. And there's a huge collision of the charge is called on Ross Travis. That is his first personal foul.
And it appeared as though there wasn't going to be any call made. A little delayed whistle right there. And let's see right there. Looks like Eliason had pretty good position. Flat foot, well, yeah.
A little shuffle there at the end.
It looked like he shuffled a little bit, so he might have caught a break there. But
you see Ross Travis isn't afraid to play physical. That large bandage above his right eye would tell you the elbow in practice the other day. That's a little bit of a friendly elbow that caught him there.
Yeah, this is grown-up basketball in a Big Ten conference, whether a game or practice situation. Got to be tough to be successful in this conference.
Stay tuned for analysis, predictions, and more on the State Farm Halftime Report.
So if you're Minnesota right now, where do you go for offense? Andre Hollins is on the floor. You've got to find him at some place to get him freed up.
Matthew gets tied up by Roberts with the quick hands. It'll stay with Minnesota with 2:08 to play in this first half.
Andre Matthew has struggled from the field, 0-4 thus far. He's a guy that can fill it up as well.
Andre Hollins with a huge bucket for Minnesota. Andre Hollins was 0-3 from the floor before he hit that shot. Travis at the free throw line. That was at home.
That's a good job of Penn State being aggressive against the pressure. You want to put pressure back on Minnesota if they do that to you. You want to try to get easy opportunities early.
Nice move by Elias and left it short. Geno Thorpe. Taylor open for three. And the rebound to Minnesota and Daquan McNeil. Matthew on the push. Nice scoop, but he cannot finish. But there's Hollins to clean it up.
Great hustle by Andre Hollins. When your best player works that hard, everybody else has to follow suit because he makes you look bad if you're not playing that hard. So Andre Hollins scrapping to get his team back into this game and get the lead once again.
103 until halftime. Penn State by two. Taylor for three. That's supposed to go down on your home run. Taylor frustrated after that popped out, but a foul inside. Gonna keep it down there. Well, that'll go rather on Otto Oceanics, and so free throws for Ross Travis.
I like the leadership of Tim Frazier pulling Brandon Taylor to the side and telling them, look, don't get frustrated. Keep shooting the rock. We got your back.
Travis's free throw is good. Our State Farm halftime report is just moments away. Dave and Jimmy hanging out in our BPN studios in Chicago. It's Wednesday night, so presented by Buffalo Wild Wings. I would assume we'll have great selection of wings.
Yeah, we better, right? That's right.
Ross Travis with the free throw, 33-29, Penn State by four.
I'm sure Dave and Jim have been talking a lot about that Michigan State-Ohio State thriller last night.
Foul here against Jordan Dickerson.
See, it's interesting. Both teams have really been trying to get to the rim, but Penn State has been very successful at drawing fouls. This is one of the few times where Matthew has put it on the deck. and come up with a positive result. Penn State's done a good job of double-teaming him on the perimeter, trying to get it out of his hands.
Matthew, an 83% free throw shooter. Look at the roll there. Good hustle by Matthew to get his own miss, but he throws it back into Woodward. Now Penn State's going to put the brakes on a little bit. A 12-second differential between the game clock and the shot clock here.
I expect a high screen and roll maybe with Tim Frazier coming back here. Right there.
And the foul is going to be called on Hollins. So Andre Hollins with his second personal foul. So the foul troubles continue to mount for both teams.
And Andre Hollins looks questioning what happened, but anytime the hand comes up and, you know, it might have been inadvertent contact, they've got to call that this season.
Free throw by Geno Thorpe is good. That points in the paint. We've talked about Penn State's change in the second part of this first half, and they've attacked inside, and they're outscoring now Minnesota in the paint 18-12 because of that attacking mentality, and it's been a big reason why Penn State's in the lead now.
Yeah, you'll hear a lot of college coaches talk about paint touches, whether it's on the bounce, whether you get big men in there, whether you get offensive rebounds. They want paint touches, and I'm sure if we had a chart of that, Penn State might be doubling up Minnesota right now in that category.
Minnesota can hold for the final shot of this first half, trailing by five. Matthew, it's 15 seconds until halftime.
Ahad Misi is a pretty good spot-up jump shooter, but this is going to be on Matthew to get something good here as the shot clock runs down.
5 seconds, Ahad Misi. Eliasson. Oh, terrible shot for Eliasson. The ball knocked away. And a half-court heave by Matthew. Good as it goes, and it's just off wide to the left. Brandon Taylor had his head in his hands. He didn't want to watch that last heave from half court. But the Nittany Lions, over the final 9:47, a 28-13 run to turn a deficit into a halftime lead.
Talk about a slumber. They got out of it just then.
35-30, Penn State with the 5-point lead at halftime. Now let's go to Dave Revson and Jim Jackson in our BTN studio for the State Farm Halftime Report. The Nittany Lion Inn, part of the National Trust for Historic Preservation on campus here. The on-campus hotel in University Park, still decked out for the holidays. 35-30, Penn State with the advantage as we get ready to start the second half. Let's take a look at tonight's All-State Mayhem Index, which features Minnesota's shooting performance against Purdue on Sunday, and then what they've done today. And you see the shooting struggles have continued or have hit today for Minnesota, especially at the free throw line.
It's been unusual because, you know, it's not to the point where they didn't have their opportunities. They got there. Andre Hollins, one of the better free throw shooters in the conference, struggled from the line as well.
Best all time at Minnesota, shooting 84% in his career. Frazier with the dish to DJ Newbill, who was saddled with foul trouble for most of the first half, and he can't hit. Andre Hollins around the Eliasson screen. And the elbow jumper rebounded by Donovan Jack.
Well, Richard Pitino talked in shoot-around today that he wanted his team to push the ball for the make or miss. He wanted to get the tempo up and look for early opportunities. Let's see if they can force their will here in the second half.
Jack trying to force that shot through two defenders. Can't hit. And Oceanix with the rebound. Here's Matthew on the drive. Matthew gets the roll.
Yeah, that's it. We're going to see Minnesota put pressure on the defense, just like Penn State did to them in the latter part of the first half, I should say.
And there's some good defensive work by Matthew. Almost got a Penn State turnover. Well, where are the Hollinses? That's the question that Minnesota fans were asking in that first half. Of course, Austin Hollins got hit with foul trouble. That limited him to just 3 points in the first half, and Andre Hollins had just 7 in that first half.
And so, you know, foul trouble and also just strong offense by Penn State, really putting a lot of pressure defensively.
Nice little floater by Frazier after he broke the pressure. That was all Tim Frazier.
Yeah, and that's what Penn State practices. You see it every day in their practice. That's one of the things they do, have the guards go to that Big Ten logo and shoot the floater.
Here's Frazier leaving it behind for Travis and a two-handed stop.
Great recognition and awareness by Tim Frazier. Look over his shoulder to see Travis filling the lane. Nice drop down and rewarding the big fella for his effort.
7-point lead for Penn State. Largest lead of the game for the Nittany Lions.
Austin Hollins has to get aggressive on the offensive end. They need his scoring.
Eliasson against Jack. Poked out of his hands, and it'll go the other way.
We see the loose ball being careless with the pass. Tim Frazier, look at the look behind him. Sees Travis going to the rim with a nice slam. And the Ross Travis typically has a good game against Minnesota. Back his mind, wanted to be recruited more heavily by the Gophers, a Shaska, Minnesota native.
DeAndre Matthew with the foul. That's his second. First on Minnesota in the second half. So Penn State off to a good start again, opening up their largest lead at 7. And 10 turnovers now for Minnesota.
Well, Penn State starting to relax now and be aggressive like this.
A little too aggressive as the charge will go against Newbill, and that's his third personal foul.
Well, let's take a look and see if Oceanix, like he was in pretty good position there. And I give our officiating crew in the Big Ten credit, man. They do an excellent job because those are not easy calls to make. And they understand how important DJ Newbill is to this Penn State attack, and yet able to step up and make that type of call.
Gene Steratore, Ray Perrone, John Gaffney, our three officials tonight. Veteran crew.
Yes.
Left a lot of big games.
Oh, nice flip by Oceanix right there.
And Oceanix with the jumper from the corner.
Really good recognition of the defense that time by Otto. Understanding they were going to double team Hollins, and the nice slip along the baseline, open jumper. That's good recognition by Oceanix.
Frazier working the dribble. Trying to go up and under there around Eliasson, and it goes out of bounds, staying with Penn State.
Okay, let's take another look and see where Oceanix is. He's set outside of the circle there. And then Oceanix slipping, understanding that Travis is a little too high to stay with him when he slips to the baseline. Excellent recognition that time by Oceanix.
John Johnson in. Newbill out with those three fouls. Rough night again for DJ Newbill. Frazier not having a rough night there. That's a two for Frazier.
Well, that confidence carrying over from the first half. And understanding there's some urgency here, much more urgency for Penn State than even Minnesota, because you don't want to drop these at home.
There's a foul call. They gave a three to Frazier on that jumper. Now they've taken that three back.
Well, you see right here, Frazier getting the lob pass. And just a little creation of space with that fake. Rhythm bounce. Oh, that's a great angle.
Great look, and you saw the toe just behind the line. That's a three. And it's 42-34. Andre Hollins off the window.
And that's pretty. You just don't see that a lot in college basketball anymore. Guys using the glass when they're going towards the rim.
Timeout taken. The pressure applied, forcing the timeout. 16:32 to go. Penn State enjoying the lead. Kevin Kugler alongside Stephen Barter. You see the score at 41-36. As of now, they've changed the Tim Frazier three to a two. But what do you think, Stephen Barto?
It's pretty clear with the black shoes behind the white line there. And it looks like they will make the change.
So they initially called it a three, then put it back to a two, and now have added the point back again. It is now a three, and it's 42-36.
And now this is a great angle because we were able to see his right foot clearly behind the white line. And right here, left and right behind the white line. So
you see it here. And that's a terrific glimpse at that right foot. That was the question. And the question has been answered. 42-36 Penn State. Now by six as Frazier gets the three credited to his account.
We'll see if Minnesota can get back in this game here in terms of some continuity. Because if they don't turn you over, if they don't get those easy buckets, they struggle to score a little bit.
Yeah, they've been rather uneven tonight, haven't they?
Yes, they have.
The jumper by Thorpe, a little short, and the push by Austin Hollins. I'd like to see Austin Hollins get going. Andre, they'll take that too as he hits the three.
Yep, starting to pick up the pace. We talked about Patino wanting his ball club to run, make, or miss.
Johnson will inbound.
Oh, almost a steal there. Austin Holland trying to play the passing lanes.
Long reach.
So he can stay a little bit away in terms of proximity from John Johnson based on his length.
And a whistle away from the ball and a foul going against Joey King, who had all kinds of foul problems in the first half. Gophers down three. Saturday, Penn State hosts the Hoosiers. Then it's Minnesota heading to East Lansing to battle Michigan State. Coverage starts at 11:30 with the tip-off show Saturday, presented by 5-Hour Energy on BTN and BTN to go. And, of course, the Big Ten are strong once again in the top 25. And Illinois getting into the top 25 now in the AP poll. Five Big Ten teams represented, including three of the top five in the nation.
An unbelievable stretch here for the Big Ten Conference. And Michigan now receiving votes as well for the top 25. So almost a repeat of last season in the depth of quality teams here each and every night.
Thorpe. Penn State up by three. Fadeaway jumper off the glass by Donovan Jack. I assume he called that.
You know he didn't. But in film tomorrow, he'll swear he did. So, guys, you didn't hear me call that?
Nice dish to King in the corner. And that three rolls away, out of bounds, off of Penn State. It'll stay with Minnesota.
Well, school is out, but the bank is open. Donovan Jack going off glass straight ahead. That's a tough shot. Nice flash to the post.
That's two times we've seen somebody use the glass with some effectiveness. They work inside on the offensive rebound and the putback by Joey King.
Joey King doing a good job and keeping his composure in spite of some foul trouble and some things that haven't gone his way, but he's staying with it. Those are great plays when you're on the road trying to steal a victory and come from behind.
First points for Joey King as DJ Newbill returns for Geno Thorpe. Newbill tonight has not scored yet. 0 for 2 from the floor. That foul trouble limited him in the first half, and Newbill's just had a hard time getting going again.
You know, and the question arises, has the ejection from last game, is there any carryover from that? Has he lost some of his confidence? Is he?
And there's a foul away as we speak of him. He commits the personal foul. DJ Newbill commits his fourth.
We talked about missed free throws and fouls becoming contagious. And Penn State unable to get DJ Newbill out of the game, I would not be surprised to see Minnesota try to go at him off the bounce. Even though Penn State's in the zone right now, Kevin, watch Austin Hollins. See if he's aggressive.
Eliasson, and he walks with it. And now that gives Penn State a chance to substitute Geno Thorpe in and Newbill out.
Yeah, and I was kind of surprised there. It looked awkward, but I didn't think Eliasson left his feet. I thought he started to shoot the jumper, but I thought he kept his foot down.
Those are big feet. You'd notice if he left those things.
That's true.
A big man out there.
That's a good point.
Johnson. Now Frazier going to work.
And Minnesota feeling a little bit better about themselves now, closing this gap, picking up the defense on every possession.
What a pass from Frazier, but Travis had it knocked away. Matthew weaving through the defense to Hollins for three. Offensive rebound, Austin Hollins. Nice bounce to Andre Hollins. Shot blocked from behind by Taylor. Johnson on the attack, and a charge is called on John Johnson. King standing in, taking the contact. He's got three fouls, does King, but the foul on Johnson goes the other way. His third.
Such a bang-bang play. John Johnson right there picks up the speed. There's contact there. Let's see. Joey King, I don't know. That's why I don't officiate. That could go either way right there.
Much to the chagrin of the folks here wearing Penn State colors that went against them. And now Minnesota with an opportunity to carve into that three-point deficit or eliminate it. Almost banked in that three, and Travis the rebound.
That's some good offensive action against the zone that time by Minnesota. Got the ball into the Big Ten emblem. Joey King looked opposite, and then the ball came back to Hollins and just missed the shot, but good execution.
Jump pass down low to Travis. Travis trying to muscle it up. Has his own rebound, and he's fouled. And Ross Travis is going to the line.
See, that's the Ross Travis that people have grown to expect here at Penn State. Undersized interior player, but doesn't lack for effort and heart.
Eliason with the personal foul. His second, team's third. So Travis, who's got the double-double, going to the line. That is his fourth double-double of the year, his ninth in his career.
And Kevin, anytime you talk to a player, so they're from the State College area, and they have to go somewhere else to school, and then they come back and play Penn State, they're not going to tell you, but they're going to bring it. And so every time Ross Travis plays Minnesota, he brings it. And, you know, it's not a hatred thing or anything. It's just it's a natural thing for players for a school that they grew up watching, wanting to play at, and they weren't able to play there. If they get a chance to play against them, there's an extra incentive there.
Super Wednesday presented by Buffalo Wild Wings. I'm Kevin Kugler alongside Stephen Bardo with Penn State leading by four at home over Minnesota. Hollins with a three. Elias in the rebound. So second chance for Minnesota, and the Gophers trying to find some offensive rhythm, shooting just 39% in the ballgame. Nice bounce down low, but Hollins couldn't handle it. Great pass by Matthew, and Austin Hollins just had it slip through his fingers.
Yeah, Matthew does an excellent job of navigating the defense, getting into the teeth of it, and usually Hollins comes up with that.
Travis on the attack against King, spinning. Taylor wanted that shot, didn't take it.
And you know what, Brandon Taylor was surprised by the pass. I don't think he expected that to come out. If he was in shooting position, that would have been up.
Tim Frazier, quiet in this second half, trying to distribute to Taylor. And Taylor with the floater to go down.
I've been really impressed by both teams against zone defenses. Their offenses against the 2-3 zone have been very, very effective.
Eliason with the attack. Put his own back up. Got the bucket and the foul. Elliot Eliason heads to the line for a chance at a three-point play. Elliot Eliason strong on the follow of his miss, and Eliason closing in on a double-double. Minnesota closing in on the Nittany Lions, down by four.
Take a look at Andre Hollins and what he's meant to this team. People know him for his scoring, Kevin, but he's also getting it done on the defensive end, and what that does, that gets your offensive game going. So now he's able to step into a couple threes. Start to lead his team back into this game.
He's got 12 points as our Auto Owners Insurance game leaders, led by Andre Hollins with 12. Tim Frazier for Penn State leading with 18 points and 7 assists. A tip of the cap to Elliot Eliason, although he misses that free throw. He's got a double-double, 10 and 10 tonight. That's his fifth of the season already.
Fifth of the season. He's got three blocks, and he's changed six other shots in the interior. So a tremendous defensive presence for the Gophers.
Nice catch by Thorpe on the high pass from Frazier. Here's Jack inside against Eliason, and Eliason swats that one out of bounds. Didn't leave his feet with the pump fake by Donovan Jack.
Must be nice, huh, to have that kind of height and be able to block shots without jumping.
Well, he is one of the most improved players in this conference. From last year to this year, he's a different post.
And you know what it is? It's confidence. I mean, you know, you have a new system. You've got a breath of fresh air. Not saying that Tubby didn't know what he was doing, because he did. But sometimes when you have a change for young players, different systems can bring different levels of confidence.
Frazier with the armbar. That is his second personal foul. And the turnover back to Minnesota. And the defense in the Big Ten for the season and for tonight, you see the block shot's a big factor for Minnesota.
Yeah, Minnesota doing a good job defending the rim. They haven't gotten the steals because they haven't been able to turn Penn State over.
Well, they're out-rebounding Penn State by just three. And it doesn't surprise you, does it, to see that block number so high, because Penn State's made such a concerted effort to attack the middle?
Definitely, and the majority of their points come from the perimeter. And with that happening, dribble penetration at the rim. Eliason and Mo Walker can stand in there and defend.
Joey King banging inside in the three-second count. Gives it back to Penn State. Turnover number 13 for the Gophers.
Mo Walker was in there trying to see if he could ice fish in the lane. Boy, he was in there quite a while.
Plenty of places around this area you can do that right now. Not there. Jack for three. And the rebound knocked away by Brandon Taylor.
And
work.
And he's not going to get credit for that. But that's yet another opportunity for his team. And that's the type of effort. When you're playing these Big Ten games, you got to give it up each and every time you're on the floor.
Johnson wanted Jack against Walker. Instead, Taylor will drive it inside, and Walker came up to touch it, tipped it off of Penn State, and it's out of bounds. There's a good play by the big man, Mo Walker.
Mo had very positive minutes in the first half as well. So, you know, the production of the front line for Minnesota is not in question. It's been Austin Hollins, his struggles.
But you can tell by the look on his face, he's really excited about what happened.
Mo Walker's got that poker face, man. You don't know either way. I think 90% of the time that's good.
Matthew on the attack. Extra pass to Malik Smith. Now inside to Walker. Working against Jack.
Blocked from behind by Frazier. He came out of nowhere. And then a foul on Matthew.
That's the second time they baited Matthew into that type of foul. Tim Frazier coming from the weak side. Excellent timing, all ball, and he recovers the ball. That's great anticipation by Tim Frazier.
Well, you love a block where he's able to keep it in play and keep it going the other way.
Yeah, and guards typically, you know, they want to throw it into the 10th row because they don't get that opportunity that often, but Tim Frazier showing you his fifth-year status.
He is extremely smart, extremely skilled, and he shows it off nearly every night on the floor. Certainly has tonight.
Great pass and two-handed stuff by Donovan Jack. What a feed from Tim Frazier.
Tim is slicing the defense up off the bounce. They cannot contain his dribble penetration. Coach Patino was worried about blow-bys, meaning that not able to keep dribble penetration out of the paint area. And it's haunting them once again tonight.
King with the fake and the drive. And King able to get the two. It's a big bucket for the Gophers. Penn State starting to grab a little momentum, but King quiets things down a little bit.
You're right. And what I'm going to be interested in seeing is if Penn State, or Minnesota rather, can put the backcourt and the frontcourt production together. They're going to be pretty tough in the conference.
Frazier will reset it with 15 on the shot clock. 4-point lead for Penn State. It's been tight throughout. Johnson, open three. And the rebound to Matthew. Now he'll push. Smith. And a whistle and a foul is going to be called. Malik Smith fouled a moment ago. 8:39 to go in the second half. And some great passing inside.
Tim Frazier has gotten into the seams of the Gopher defense time and time again. And then Joey King, determined, had a little Fred Astaire going there at the rim and got away with it. That's, man, I shouldn't have said that because that's old school.
I was going to say.
Fred Astaire. I've got kids on their iPhones right now like, who is Fred Astaire?
Free throw good for Malik Smith. He gets the bonus. 17 fouls against Penn State. 4 against Minnesota with 8:39 to go. That means Minnesota, the best free throw shooting team in the Big Ten, will go to the free throw line from here on out. However, they've not been the best at the line tonight. They've really struggled in that first half.
And when you see 2 free throws go down by Malik Smith, remember how we said things are contagious at the free throw line? Maybe now the Gophers start finding their rhythm once again.
Johnson, the 3. And a long rebound to who else? Tim Frazier. He's doing it all tonight. And then it's out of bounds. Off his leg to Minnesota.
Aggressive hands of the Gophers in that trap situation. Taught to dig on the ball. Frazier runs it down, but watch the hands. Malik Smith, Austin Hollins, right there. The active hands going after the basketball. The Gophers do that as well as anyone in the conference.
Joey King, he's been more aggressive offensively of late, but that pass knocked out by John Johnson.
Good job by John Johnson, sealing the backside defensively. Oceanix looked like he was going to have an open layup, but good fundamental defense there by the Nittany Lions.
Oceanix in the corner to Hollins for 3. A one-arm rebound by Ross Travis. Penn State by 2 with the ball. Frazier is going to back it out. Penn State slowing things down again.
Yeah, they are, and trying to pick apart this zone. They've had really good success with these 2 high picks here. Frazier will try to get around. Minnesota right now doing a good job of keeping him inside of those screens.
Well, you've liked how both teams have attacked the zone tonight. Here's Roberts for 3. That won't go. Offensive rebound, Jordan Dickerson. Nice catch by Roberts. Big man throwing a pass about as tall as he was. Frazier, nice bounce again, and a foul will send Ross Travis to the line. Tim Frazier's a magician out there. That ball's on a string, and he's putting it wherever he wants to put it. Another great feed by Tim Frazier is going to give Penn State the chance to do some work at the line. This one to Travis, who draws the foul. He'll shoot when we return. Penn State 49, Minnesota 47. 7:11 to play here in University Park. Tomorrow night, it's a doubleheader of women's hoops action. First, Michigan State hosts Nebraska. Then it's Penn State taking on Illinois. Coverage starts at 7 Eastern tomorrow on BTN and BTN to go. And, of course, we talk about the men's side and how strong it is in the Big Ten Conference. The women's side giving the men every bit of run for their money. That is an awfully, awfully good grouping of women's basketball teams on the women's side in the Big Ten Conference, and we've got a couple of great ones going tomorrow night.
I would agree, and you know that Indiana team has been the surprise of the league thus far.
What a start.
And you called a really good game at Northwestern at Nebraska. I guess that was last week.
A week ago tomorrow night. Yeah. Nebraska and Northwestern opened up conference play against each other. Went down to a 1-point game. So. Yeah.
And the tie to that game to this game, the one ex-Gopher player, Richard Coffey, his daughter. What's her first name?
Nia.
Nia Coffey plays for Northwestern. So, you know, I'm getting old when my competitor's kids are in the Big Ten playing basketball now.
Ladies and gentlemen, that's how a professional broadcaster ties that conversation into the game you see on your television. Matthew in the paint with the floater, and it's a 2-point game. And a timeout taken by Minnesota. 6:46 to go, second half. Gophers down 2 as Richard Pitino wants to talk things over after Matthew got that penetration that he's so known for. He's been a real revelation offensively this year for Minnesota.
He really has, and the viewers at home, there's nothing wrong with your television. That was DeAndre Matthew. That wasn't Tim Frazier or John Johnson, what you've seen from Penn State. Matthew has the same shot in his repertoire, that floater that all good guards getting into the paint need to have.
He's one of 3 major conference players under 5'10", averaging double figures this year. DeAndre Matthew averaging 11.5 points per game.
Tonight, it's the finale presented by Reese's. Our guys in the studio break down the full night of basketball with highlights and analysis tonight at 11 Eastern on BTN.
They're going to have a good one here to break down. I also think that the next one, Illini invade the Kohl Center. We'll see if the Illini can overcome what has been, to me, one of the most impressive starts in the country, not just with their record, but in the way that Wisconsin and the different styles of play they've been able to go against.
Newbill back on the floor. DJ Newbill has really struggled tonight from an offensive standpoint. He has not, however, as Frazier cannot hit that three. Matthew with the rebound. Newbill still looking for his first points of the night. And Matthew, as he stopped at the elbow, a whistle and a foul. Crowd wanted to travel. They thought he slid. Instead, the foul is going to go on Tim Frazier.
There was a lot of contact coming up the floor, like right there. They're bumping. He reached again. And like an accumulation, I guess, for him to get that call.
Front end of the one and one is good for DeAndre Matthew. Second one with a chance to tie this game. So Minnesota now 10 of 19 at the line.
Watch Minnesota. They press whether they make or miss on free throws. So 2-2-1, three-quarter court pressure. See how Penn State handles it this time.
Six minutes to go in a tie game between Penn State and Minnesota.
Penn State against the zone likes to get Tim Frazier into the middle of the zone and then make plays.
Ross Travis making a play, caught the rim, and got the bucket.
Now Penn State going back to man-to-man, so a nice chess match between Richard Pitino and Pat Chambers.
Matthew eyeing that defense with 17 to shoot. Not a lot of movement right now from Minnesota offensively. Hollins trying to change that, driving it to the well. And the rebound ripped away by Allen Roberts. And then a whistle and a foul. Hollins still down, reaching up and fouling Dickerson. So Hollins gets his third.
I need to look at this on the replay. I think I got blocked out a little bit because I didn't see.
Kind of pulled him down, it looked like.
I thought he was protecting himself. You know, when you see a seven-footer getting ready to step on your head, you kind of put your arm up. That was an unfortunate break there for Andre Holland.
Two-point lead for Penn State with the ball. 5:05 to play in this second half. Frazier. Over the lattice and the bucket and the foul.
That's just too easy. That's too easy. He sat there and caught the basketball, Kevin, looked at the defense and said, I'm getting ready to drive on you and go right to the rim. And he's able to do it with relative ease. I know that's not your average guard. He's one of the best that we have, but you've got to play better defense than that in that scenario. It's just too easy.
20 points now for Frazier. And he gets his own rebound. The 26th time in his career he's had 20 points or more. That's the best in the Big Ten. Nobody has more 20-point games than the man with the ball in his hand right now. DJ Newbill still looking for his first points of the night. Here's Frazier. Ripped away and taken away by Austin Hollins. Matthew ripped out of his hands and a foul. Newbill crashing in to get a piece of that one.
Wow, he's that aggressive with four fouls, and now he picks up his fifth? You see right here, Matthew wasn't really even going to shoot. It looked like he was going to try to dump it off. And Newbill, over-aggressive there with four fouls. I mean, I know he hasn't scored yet tonight, Kevin, but you got to let him go. Allow and trust your teammates with a four-point lead to do defense.
No points tonight, and DJ Newbill fouls out. So a bad Saturday turns into a worse Wednesday for DJ Newbill after being ejected at Illinois with just 7 points, now is fouled out without a single point, and yet his team leads by four.
Isn't that something? It's been a game that defies statistics for sure in terms of the different ebb and flow that we've witnessed tonight.
Two shots.
It's just very unusual to see a guy that's prolific on the offensive end have a donut.
First time, obviously, this year that he's gone scoreless. Ross Travis has certainly picked up some of the slack tonight for Penn State. 17 points, 11 rebounds as Matthew hits both free throws to bring the Gophers within two.
Now they go back into, now they go to the man-to-man pressure, not 2-2-1, but full-court man-to-man pressure.
Travis breaks that. Taylor.
Big bucket for three for Penn State.
Not settling just to break the defense, but putting pressure on Minnesota and penalizing them for the pressure.
Matthew on the drive with the answer for the Gophers, back within three.
Both teams tomorrow in practice, Kevin, will be practicing defense off the dribble, trying to contain dribble penetration. Both teams have been poor at that here, especially in the second half.
Frazier. Thorpe with 16 to shoot, forcing it up, and he gets the contact and the foul. That'll be number four on Austin Hollins, and a 58-55 lead for Penn State.
Well, you talk about being aggressive against the pressure. Brandon Taylor didn't hesitate, and then DeAndre Matthew trying to keep his team in it.
23 at the free throw line in the first half. They were just 7 of 15 at the line.
Yeah, for the conference's best free throw shooting team, it just happens like that certain games. Snowball effect.
Collins good on both. And a 2-point game with 3:23 to go.
Penn State's done a really good job of handling the pressure for the most part. Their turnovers, Penn State's, have been in the half court trying to be aggressive at the rim, but they really haven't turned it over against the pressure from Minnesota.
Frazier. To shoot for Frazier. In the corner. No good on the three, but a foul is called as Tim Frazier went in to try to get the rebound, and a little push called against Minnesota. And that's on Austin Hollins.
See, right there, like Austin Hollins trying to box out right there.
Austin Hollins is obviously the strongest man in the Big Ten. Did you see the way Tim Frazier tumbled all the way across the lane after that contact?
Yeah, he might have been taking a few drama classes lately, huh?
The People's Choice Award.
There you go.
Matthew. King, that was the fourth foul on Austin Hollins a moment ago.
Well, this is going to be interesting. Minnesota team now, first time on the road on the patina. Let's see how they respond.
Boy, Eliason with the turnover. Great poke out for Penn State. And now the Nittany Lions with a 2-point lead and 2.5 to go, with a chance to add to that lead and burn some clock. Here's the guy they want to have the ball in his hands, Tim Frazier. Back it goes to Taylor. A little bit strong, Eliason with the rebound. He's got a double-double tonight. Here's Hollins on the drive. Hollins inside, and a foul is going to be called. Hollins gets two free throws.
Looked a little out of control there, like he didn't quite have control of the bounce, but forced the contact and got the foul.
Coach Chambers not in agreement.
Challenges the inside-out dribble. Looks like John Johnson got his hand on the ball before the contact was made. So almost right there, almost could have been called a jump ball.
And Tim Frazier came up limping and limps over to the Penn State bench after that play. We talk about every Penn State fan with a collective gasp. That's the last place you want to see Tim Frazier.
And that looked like a cramp when you grab Gatorade and somebody starts, one of the trainers starts pulling on your calf. Hopefully that's just a cramp.
Of course, after missing all of last year with the injury, Tim Frazier back and as good or better than ever. Frazier just getting stretched out and massaged over there. That's, as you said, Stephen, that's a pretty good sign if you're a Penn State fan. See if we can see anything on the replay.
I don't see him on the right side. And
looking for the travel call. You don't notice anything there. And then all of a sudden that calf muscle looked like it locked up.
Yeah, he may even have a Charlie horse that happens in the back of your knee and comes down from your hamstring. It just another form of a cramp, and hopefully that's all it is.
Now the question becomes now, who provides the offense for Penn State in the final 208 if Frazier can't get back in? Newbill fouls out. Frazier on the bench with an injury.
And so now you have to give the ball to John Johnson, who this is only his fourth game as a Nittany Lion. So he's got the experience from Pitt, but this is a foreign situation for him. So it'd be interesting to see if Frazier doesn't come back, what Pat Chambers calls up.
Austin Hollins has struggled tonight. Just 4 points for Hollins. But a one-point game with 2:07 to play. Thorpe against Hollins.
Looks like Geno Thorpe, freshman, wants to step up and initiate the offense.
And he turns it over. Hollins with a steal. Austin Hollins to the other end. The layup is no good, but the tip is up and in. And the Gophers take the lead with a minute 42 to go.
Unbelievable play by Austin Hollins. Got the steal without the foul. Pushes it up, and his teammate cleans the bucket.
Great defense again by Austin Hollins.
Now look at that. Perfect technique. Uses his outside hand to avoid the foul. Goes strong to the hole. And DeAndre Matthew doesn't quit on the play. But Hollins, look at that. Uses his length. When you use the outside arm, you avoid the foul. Good job by Austin Hollins.
Let's check in with Dave Revson in our BTN studio in Chicago.
Well, Kevin, we get a good look at Trayvon Jackson. Better than 10 points, 4 rebounds, and 4 assists. Only Devin Harris and Jordan Taylor have hit those totals in Wisconsin in the last 18 years. Good point guard matchup as he squares off with Tracy Abrams. 5 straight games in double figures coming in. Illini and Badgers coming up here on BTN next.
That's going to be a great one, Dave. Wisconsin, one of the 5 remaining unbeatens in NCAA men's basketball. And they'll get a stiff test tonight from Coach Gross's Illini squad. Frazier is back on the court for Penn State with the ball in his hands. His team down 1, Minnesota leading for the first time in the second half.
And he's grimacing a little bit as he was bringing the ball up. See if he's shaking off that injury that sent him to the sideline.
12 to shoot. Frazier. 8 for Johnson. Johnson, the 3. And the rebound to Ross Travis. And Travis is fouled. And Ross Travis is going to get 2 free throws. The foul going against Minnesota's Joey King.
Well, contested 3. Comes up short, and Ross Travis would not be denied on the offensive end. Goes in and gets a big-time rebound. And right here, like Joey King had him boxed out, but Travis fouling him out.
King is out with those 5 fouls. Minnesota with 1:06 remaining in the second half with a 1-point lead, but the 10th team foul means 2 free throws for Ross Travis.
And so right now, if you're Richard Pitino, you're going over different scenarios with your ball club. If he makes both, we do this. If he makes 1, we do this. If he misses, we do this. So there's 3 different scenarios that he's given his team, even though he has 3 timeouts. You always want to constantly remind your players of time and situation.
Travis 5-for-7 at the line tonight, 67% on the year. one more to try to tie it.
Travis would like nothing better than to step up and tie this up and continue his stellar night.
He's got the double-double, 18 points, 12 rebounds for Travis. Tie game with a minute to play here in State College. And the ball knocked away, and a foul's going to be called on Tim Frazier. And that is number five on Frazier. He fouls out with 20 points, 8 assists, and 5 rebounds.
And you could tell that Tim Frazier knew he fouled him because there was not much. He didn't, you know, talk to the referee or anything like that. He knows that he fouled him on that situation. Usually a player is adamant going back towards the referee and right there, and it looked like Andre Holland got away with the walk before he threw that pass. Right? Mm. Yeah, he changed pivot number feet there. Right across the arm, right there.
Boy. And so Tim Frazier is out. DJ Newbill out. One of the top scoring duos in the country. On the bench for the final 58 seconds of regulation in a tie game.
So for a veteran backcourt, we've seen some questionable decision-making, both by Frazier and Newbill, in very critical situations.
Free throw no good by Oceanix. And the top free throw shooting team in the conference continuing to struggle, 16 of 27 at the line tonight. And now Minnesota by one. Who will provide the offense now for Penn State?
It's got to be John Johnson.
Yeah, like Minnesota pressuring here when they try to find who's going to handle the ball with Frazier and Newbill gone. They've got to hurry. Johnson across. And now 25 to shoot for Penn State. And a pocket picked. Matthew with a steal. Matthew with a layup. And Minnesota leads by three. Now they want to push. Thorpe on the attack. Drive into the basket. And he is fouled. He'll go to the line for two.
All night long, Tim Frazier had the basketball up front, and Matthew was guarding him, but not once was he able to time the dribble like he did against John Johnson right there. Huge play by Minnesota, but Patino wasn't happy because Matthew was smiling. They were jogging, getting back. And now Penn State pushes it right back at them.
Two-point game.
So you can never relax. You know, you make a great play, and Matthew kind of smiles at the bench, but then Thorpe runs up the side and draws a foul because Minnesota's not back defensively.
Kevin Montminy is about ready to come off the bench for the first time tonight. Second free throw, no good. Tip try, no good. And a whistle and a foul. And now Penn State with a chance to tie it at the line. Elliot Eliason with the foul.
Let's take a look. Crashing the glass. It looked like Eliason got the arm of Travis. And interesting thing you saw there, both Oceanix and Eliason got pushed under the basket, so they've got to hold their rebound position better in this situation.
And the free throw no good. Penn State now 18 of 28 at the line. Each team leaving 10 points or more at the free throw line tonight.
We see this sometimes in college basketball where neither team seems like they really want to win in these scenarios. Nobody coming up filling the void.
Well, let's take a look back a couple of years as we jump into the Wayback Machine. On February 6th, 2010 in University Park, the Gophers and Nittany Lions went down to the wire. 9 seconds left. Taylor Battle ties the game at 64. But Minnesota got the last word as Lawrence Westbrook hit an 18-footer as time expired, giving the Gophers a 66-64 win on the road and crushing Penn State's hopes of a victory at home. Will we see history repeat itself tonight between these two teams? 35.4 seconds to go in a two-point game.
See, the likelihood of that happening is severely diminished because Frazier and Newville, their two leading scorers, are fouled out of the game.
Ross Travis, who's tied his career high in rebounds, now needs to hit some free throws. He's got 13 boards, 6 of 10 at the line. Cannot hit the free throw, and Eliasson with the rebound and a foul immediately to send Eliasson to the other end for two.
Well, he wasn't pushing underneath the bucket that time. He made sure that he got good position and anticipated the miss.
Eliasson tonight, 10 points, 12 rebounds, but not a bad guy to have at the line. 2 for 6 tonight. Normally a pretty solid free throw shooter.
He's got solid form, but again, this is all concentration and focus for both of these clubs, and they just don't have it tonight.
2 for 7 now for Eliasson at the free throw line. Malik Smith back on the floor for Minnesota. Out goes Oceanix.
A lot of sprints and then going to the free throw line. And then sprints in practice tomorrow, and then back to the free throw line.
1 for 2 for Eliasson. 3-point lead. Penn State without Frazier, without Newbill. Who will provide the offense? Brandon Taylor to the basket. Brings Penn State within one. And the Nittany Lions use their final timeout with 25.3 seconds to play.
That's an excellent decision by Brandon Taylor. Typically, you see guys try to settle for three to get it all back. He gets to the rim, cuts the lead to one. They can set up defensively after they call timeout. Nice job. Taylor wanted the pick and pop for the three, but then saw Eliasson was off balance defensively and got to the rim. It's an excellent play by Brandon Taylor.
Normally you'd say Minnesota in this situation has a clear advantage as the top free throw shooting team in the Big Ten Conference, but tonight is not a normal night. So if you're Penn State, who do you look for to foul here?
Well, in terms of free throw percentage shooting, you don't want to foul Austin Hollins because he's one of the better shooters, as you mentioned, in Gopher history. If I'm Penn State, it looks like Eliasson, Austin Hollins, Andre Hollins, Matthew, and maybe Malik Smith in the game. I might go with Malik Smith, even though he's a very good outside free throw or outside three-point shooter. He hasn't been in quite a while.
Team that shoots 76% on the year at the line, but tonight just 60%, 18 of 30. And it will be Hollins, Matthew, Smith, and Eliasson. As Mr. Bardo mentioned a moment ago, those are the five on the floor for the Gophers. 25.3 seconds to play. 1-point game for the Gophers on the road.
And Elliot Eliasson will be the safety gap. So if they can't get the ball to Andre Hollins or DeAndre Matthew, they'll throw it high to Eliasson, and let him go get it.
Guard the inbound with Roberts guarding Hollins. Into Smith. Malik Smith is fouled with 23.9 seconds to go. And Smith, an 85% free throw shooter, but as you mentioned, he's not been on the floor for quite some time, just sitting over on that bench watching his teammates miss free throws.
That's right. So, you know, you play the percentages, you play the situation. Let's see if Smith can step up and knock these down.
The senior transfer from Florida International. Game with Richard Pitino to Minnesota, and Smith hits the first.
Boy, he looked confident on that shot, too, didn't he?
He sure did. Third best bench average in the Big Ten, averaging nearly 10 points per game this year. And calmly hits both free throws. Penn State out of timeouts. 3-point game for Minnesota. On the drive to the bucket and got the roll, John Johnson. Extending the game by taking the two.
I love that approach.
And now the foul will send Smith right back to the line. That foul on Allen Roberts. That's his third. Two free throws here for Malik Smith, who hit two very calmly a moment ago.
I thought John Johnson was going to try to create some space to get a three-point shot off, but I love, as you said, Kevin, extending the game, getting to the rim, and making Minnesota make their free throws, which they have not done tonight.
Smith, however, in crunch time, has come up big. He is 0 for 5 from the floor, but 5 for 5 at the line. still perfect for Malik Smith. Three-point game. Penn State looking for offense. No Newbill, no Frazier. Both have fouled out. Newbill didn't score tonight. Johnson with 8 seconds. The long three. A little bit strong. Offensive rebound for Taylor. Backs it out. The guarded three for Roberts. Can't get the roll. And Minnesota survives on the road to knock off Penn State 68-65. The final at the Bryce Jordan Center. Gophers are now 2-1 in conference and 13-3 on the season. Penn State 0-3.
Well, Penn State had a couple good looks at it. That was under duress, but this was a really good look. It looked online from our vantage point, just didn't fall for Allen Roberts. So another heartbreaking loss for the Penn State.
And once again, our final score, Minnesota 68, Penn State 65. Coming up next on the Big Ten Network, Illinois and Wisconsin. The proceeding has been an exclusive presentation.